Hey guys, this is Martin again from Surge Electronics, and today I'm going to teach you how to calculate how many strips you can run per power supply. That's the power consumption or the current consumption of the strips related to the power supplies. We're going to use today the dual density and single density strips compared to the 400 watt power supply as an example. So let me step over to my whiteboard and I'll show you guys the basic math that we use to figure this out. So basically, what we're going to be doing is we're going to show you how to divide the consumption of the strips by the capacity of the power supply. All of our strips have data sheets which tell you the max consumption at full intensity. That's for the RGB and for the whites and all different sorts of strips, either 50-50, 35-28. All of them have a amperage consumption data sheet. So today we're going to talk about the RGB dual density and single density, just to give you guys an idea on how to do it, and we're going to compare it all using a 400 watt power supply. So the dual density strip consumes right around 48 watts. Okay, that's a full intensity with all the colors and everything on all the way. And then the single density consumes right around 23 watts. Give or take a watt or two, so that's pretty much what it is. And we're going to be using a 400 watt power supply, okay? And this right here, the 400 watts, that's the capacity of the power supply. But a power supply, you never want to run it at full capacity, because what you run risk of is getting it too hot, and that will shorten the life of your power supply, not to mention other issues that could arise from that. So now that you know your power supply capacity, and now you know what your strips consume, then you can figure everything out using very simple math. So the way you do it, you get the capacity of the power supply, which is 400 watts, and you divide it by the 48 watts of which is what your strip is consuming. This is the 48 watts for the dual density strip. Once you do this basic math problem, it comes out to about 8, okay, give or take. So that's 8 strips, 8 dual density strips that you could put on there. And you can say, okay, great, I could just put 8 of them in there, no problem, right? But the issue with doing that is that you're going to be running your power supply at full capacity. And, you know, we already talked about the issues with that. So, you know, you could get thermal issues and a bunch of other issues that it's best to avoid. So now that we know 8 is 100%, if we do 6, that'll be 75% of the capacity. So we do 6 dual density RGB strips, okay? That will equal to right around 350 watts or so, okay? That right there is about 75% capacity of the 400 watts, which will be perfect to run the strip at. So 6 strips would be the maximum that you could run safely without running into any issues or anything like that. So the same procedure goes for the single density and for pretty much any other strip. Whether it's a 400 watt power supply, we also offer the 96 watt, the 200 watt, and the 150 watt waterproof power supplies. So it's the same procedure. All you got to do is plug in the numbers. Let's say it's you know, 96 watt power supply and you're using single density strips. You put in 96 watt, 23 watts down here for the single density, and then you get your maximum number, and then you calculate that to get a 75% capacity, 80%, that's pushing it, and that'll give you, you know, how many strips you could do safely. So that's pretty much all there is to it. It's a very simple math problem that you use. So there's not a whole lot of crazy science or anything like that. So if you guys have any other questions, any concerns, anything like that, don't forget to drop us a comment there in the comment box. Also, don't forget to subscribe and check out our website at surge-e.com. Thanks for watching.